What's up, Matadors? This is Victoria Ramirez.
And Isaiah Ramirez with your MatCast episode for April 13th, 2018.
On this show, we'll take a look at this year's art collage and some current news with 1 minute in the world.
Finally, you'll hear from Mr. Boucher and some of his students about the animation class.
This is MatCast. One of the most diverse events of the year is the art collage. With band, choir, mariachi, and art all collaborating at once, it turned out to be a very special event. We talked to some of the students to see what made it so special.
My name is Joshua Sanchez. I participated in mariachi and in band, and I am a senior at Seguin High School. The arts collage is when all the fine arts get together and they show off what they've been working on for the school year. And we have concerts, they have viewings of arts, and they just have everything, like performances.
My name is Agar Wonka, and I'm a junior. And for the Fine Arts Collage, I was with choir and band. Some of the programs involved in the Arts Collage are choir, band, theater, mariachi, and art. It's a special event for the school because even though these programs have concerts separately, you can see them simultaneously. So if you want to go see choir for a moment, you can see a solo, then you can go to band, you can go to theater and see all the arts exhibits. What you can't do separately, let's say if you can't make to a concert on a separate day.
Made it a special event because it gets to showcase what the fine arts have been working on during the school year and how it helps the community around, and it also like shows, like say your student is in fine arts, it gets to show off what they've done and what they've accomplished.
I've seen it grown tremendously, yes, because there are so many people appreciating it now from a younger age, and now our programs get to grow throughout the years. And so me being a junior now, I have seen all the freshmen, sophomores that have come in for each program, such as choir and band and theater.
My favorite part was when the wind ensemble got together and we just performed with all the fine arts, like choir and mariachi, and we brought in Mr. Malden's son and we played Rhapsody in Blue. So that was really neat, bringing us all together as one.
Another program in the school that involves a form of art is the animation class. For the past few years, Mr. Boucher has been helping his students improve in every field, from video games to graphic design. We talked to Mr. Boucher and some of his students to see what it's like to be a part of the class.
My name is Mr. Boucher. I teach 3D animation, digital media, and game programming. I've been fascinated by animation since about the PS2 era, when I was playing video games and some of them came out with behind the scenes. And to me, that was like looking behind the curtain, and I was very fascinated in seeing how games were made, even more so than playing them. I enjoyed the process of watching how they were developed. And then so I pursued that in college, and after graduating, I got the privilege to pass that down to the students and show them how it's done. And I've been doing that for about 2 years now.
My name is Esmeralda Leija. I'm a junior. I wanted to join animation because it's something that I've been interested, like growing up watching the animation movies, it was something that I found nice.
Animation is the illusion of life. But here in class, we do sequential images that when arranged in order, create fake movement.
My name is Ryan Gonzalez and I'm in the 11th grade. What made me want to do animation class that was it seemed like fun and it didn't feel like work.
For 2D animation, we have storyboarding, which lays out the process of the actual shot itself. Then they create the actual characters with a character sheet, which tells them the color theory and schemes for their character. And then they'll actually start animating in Flash. Now for 3D animation, they still have the character sheets and the storyboards, but they have to develop the mesh for their characters, that's the 3D skin of their character, the outside appearance, and after that they can finally keyframe their animation and then render it, and that's the final animation that you get.
I can't really say if I prefer 2D or 3D animation, I enjoy both. For 2D animation, like sometimes drawing the stuff, because for 2D you actually have to continuously draw it, so it kind of gets hard, like you get tired of drawing the same thing sometimes. For 3D, it's just sometimes trying to create the objects in a certain way.
Some of my personal favorite projects that we've worked on for the 2D animations are the ones that tell the simple stories that I think are more fun to empathize with. And for 3D, I like the ones that tend to be more technical and are more visually stunning, but I still enjoy the stories for those as well. But I feel that the technical aspects shine out more in 3D than in 2D, because you can have the processing software do a lot of it for you as long as you code it correctly.
The difficult things about animation, that's learning new things and seeing if it works.
That's what I'm thinking of pursuing as a career, animation or graphic design. So that's another reason why I took this class.
Kids should join my animation class if they have any interest in 3D animation or game design or even 2D animation, just the art form itself. And I have a few anime students in here as well.
This is Wyatt Smith.
And Karen Rampt with 1 Minute in the World. The chemical attack on Syria this past weekend has left the United States on the verge of military confrontation with the Syrian government. It is estimated that the attack left 80 Syrians dead and hundreds more injured. Although the Syrian government refuses to take responsibility for the attack, it is suspected that the attack was caused due to rebel forces which controlled the town.
Mark Zuckerberg, the CEO of Facebook, testified earlier this week in front of Congress. This is in light of the Cambridge Analytica privacy scandal, in which the data of some 87 million Facebook users fell into the hands of a research firm that worked with the Trump campaign.
Plans have been made by President Donald Trump to send National Guard troops to the Mexican-American border. These troops are meant to hinder illegal immigration until the president's wall has been built. The plan will most likely allow for troops to fight illegal immigration without actually contacting the immigrants.
Well, that's it for today's episode. This has been Victoria Ramirez.
And Isaiah Ramirez.
Have a great weekend, SHS.
First of all,
come on, push.
No,
I was always the last one to catch the ball in elementary. So, 2, 3, 4.
Bye.